All right, so how should we solve it? Well, my approach is going to be to use a tree, or another way to think of this is to use recursion. Let's say that we start out with our possible guests remaining to be LM, ECS, and SBA. And the people who've showed up, let's say right now that's zero. And I'm going to walk through and diagram a tree that shows all eight possibilities. Let's say I start out with three guests to invite, and I'm going to pick the first one right now. One possibility is that LM shows up. Another possibility is that LM does not. So now I have two other worlds to consider. In this first one, LM has showed up, and I still have to invite ECS and SBA and see what happens. Over here, no one has showed up, but I still have to invite ECS and SBA. Let's work here on the left first. Now it's time to invite ECS. One possibility is that she shows up. Another possibility is that she does not, but since LM showed up earlier, she's still here. In any event, I still have to invite or consider SBA. Let's say I do invite SBA. One possibility is that she shows up. Another possibility is that she does not. And now I'm out of people to consider inviting, so we're done over here on the left. Back over here in this possible world, only LM has shown up so far. Let's go invite SBA. One possibility is that SBA shows up. Another possibility is that she does not. And you can see how this pattern would repeat in the other side of the tree. I'll just do it here quickly. And now at the bottom of the tree, you can see all eight of our answers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, ranging from everyone shows up to no one shows up. In this tree, every time we go down a level, every time we consider another guest, we have two branches. So the size of the tree doubles each time, which is just what we reasoned about before. In this particular running example, my three friends that I invited for dinner, LM, ECS, and SBA, were Lucretia Mott, Elizabeth Cady Stanton, and Susan B. Anthony, three American abolitionists, that is, they opposed slavery, who then went on to champion women's right to vote. All right, so how am I going to implement this? I'm going to make a recursive procedure that has two arguments, one corresponding to the remaining people to invite, and another corresponding to who has showed up so far. Unlike many other recursive procedures, I'm going to call myself recursively twice. Once in the case where the current person accepts, once in the case where they don't. All right, so here we are in the interpreter, the integrated development environment. We're going to write a procedure that accepts a list as an argument and then prints out all the subsets of that list.